Hi folks, and welcome to a video which is very much a call for help. Now, if you've followed me for any length of time, you'll know that what I've done with electronics so far has very much been a case of hacking things. I've never learnt electronics properly, and although I've now sorted out some courses, life is as life does, and I haven't started those yet. But I have pretty much a real-world need, and that need is to repair an outside PIR-driven LED light. Now, it's been in service for quite a number of years, and this was the PIR that has pretty much failed. It was connected to this circuit board via a couple of connectors which don't match what I bought to replace it. I had very little to go on, and I was just making it up as I went along, as per normal. Now this is a DC 12 volt PIR, and I've got it working after a fashion. If I just connect the live here, we have a 6 volt lead acid battery, and it should, well, it's sort of functioning. I've got the sensitive and lux and all the rest of it turned so that it'll come on the desk. So as you can see, it's pretty much live into the PIR, live out of the PIR to the LED, and everything sharing a common neutral, which is all nice and good, but my problem now is charging the battery. Forget these. These are pretty much not doing very much. So, I've got to charge the battery. But I know enough to know that I don't know enough. If that makes any kind of sense. I know that if I connect the solar panel directly to the battery, then I'm going to face a couple of problems. One is that the voltage in the battery would potentially wreck the solar panel, and also that the solar panel is putting out enough voltage to potentially boil the lead acid. Now that's a 6 volt battery, and if I show you what's going on here, even under this light it's putting out 9 volts DC. That's higher than the battery even under this desk lamp. So as you can see, my movement is triggering the it's functioning as it should. My only concern is that this is a 12 volt DC unit, and although it seems to be functioning, I'm wondering if the 6 volts out of the battery is going to be enough to allow this to have enough sensitivity outside when I put it out there. But yeah, this in service has done a number of things. The switch, as you can see, is totally corroded, so I had to cut that out of the circuit, and that was when I pretty much worked out what was going on. This circuit is pretty much not doing very much at all, but the DC, I still have the DC input from the solar panel going into that circuit, just in case I'm able, or was able, to take some feeds off here. Yeah. Spiderweb. I mean, this is supposed to be a sealed unit. How the hell did spiders get in here? The chip, I think, is some sort of battery control charge chip, but it's got nothing on it. I'm pretty sure that something in here is what was advertised. Ugh. Let's just turn this off. Now, I did go onto the EEV blog, but I think that on some of the forums there, they have a higher barrier of entry and assume knowledge that I haven't got. And it was mentioned about a Schottky diode to put that in between the solar panel and the battery and connect it up. I'm not really sure, because a Schottky diode appears to have 3 pins, not 2. And I'm still not really clear how I should be wiring it up. But even if I do put a Schottky diode in the live feed from the panel to the battery, I know that I'll still be effectively boiling the battery, and I don't know what overvoltage is going to do to this. So basically what I need is some circuit to basically, I think I'm going to have to cut these off here, abandon this circuit, because it was obviously built for something, well, it was built for this PIR, and it's obviously got something in it, because it's already biased, well, built rather, for the solar panel to charge this battery. So there must be some circuitry going on here to do the job, and that's why I feel that I can just take those from there, feed them to the battery, and just put those in the appropriate place on this circuit to take the feed from the solar panel, and that should safely charge the battery without boiling it, and also protect the solar panel as well. But I've got no clue what I'm doing. I am totally lost, and I don't even know if the 6 volts from this battery will be enough to drive this PIR at the sensitivity that it needs to be outside. So basically that's what I need help with. I need a circuit diagram that I'll be able to work from to do what I need to do. I've pretty much given up attempting to understand what this circuit is doing, even though I'm pretty sure that this circuit is doing what I need to do. I just don't know where I'm cutting in. So if anyone can help me on this, that would be superb, because I'm basically, I'm at a loss. I know what I need to do, or rather what I need to avoid doing. It's just a case that I know enough to know that I don't know enough, and I need help. So if you can help, please. So thanks for watching this, and I'll catch you on the next one. Bye for now.